to Mayor Michael Thompson. Thank you for taking the time to be with us. We are Brightline and we are focused in helping organizations transforming their ideas into reality. We've seen over the past few years that the city of Toronto is moving and moving fast. So we'd be interested in learning and hearing from you, what is the city of Toronto doing and making things happen?
Well, thank you very much, Shairu. It's a pleasure to be with you. The City of Toronto is doing many different things in order to take advantage of the talent that's here, talented men and women, and also the new immigrants who come into our city. Many countries around the world are closing their borders to immigrants, and we are of a view that immigration creates opportunity and prosperity. And so what we're doing in Toronto, based in our institutions, our colleges, our universities, our high schools, our public school system, we're educating our population to ensure that they have the tools to take on the challenges that innovation brings, that technology brings to the forefront, that development opportunity brings to the city, that transit that is needed in the city, we're focusing attention on. So we're operating in a variety of different areas that is important to our city's health and well-being. We also focus in on the cultural landscape as well. So in as much as we are about technology, we're about education, we're about innovation, we're also innovation in the arts and cultural sector, the music scene, the film and television industry. So what we're trying to do, because we know that people have a variety of different interests, we're trying to cater to all those interests in a collective, planned way to ensure that all of our cylinders, economic cylinders, are working really well. We take the position that diversity is our strength in the city. And we know that what really is important to all city is talent. So we encourage talent development. We invest in opportunities in talent, in people, as well as in industries as well, so that they themselves will be able to hire, to retain talent. And the landscape that we keep here in the City of Toronto, so that people, for example, have got great parks, great trails, great waterways and so on, good air to breathe in and a healthy society. We invest in after-school programs. We invest in daycares. We actually invest in, lunch programs and breakfast programs in our schools to make sure no young person goes without eating a meal and so on, because people are busy. And at the same time, we try to improve the quality of life for everybody.
So how is the vision for the City of Toronto from a technology perspective? How technology is shaping the City of Toronto?
Sure. I mean, well, technology is shaping, I think, the universe. The City of Toronto being part of that. We are using it from a number of different ways, whether or not it's to monitor and manage how we deliver water supply to our population, whether or not it's our configuration with respect to our traffic signals, traffic lights, because as you know, it's a big city, lots of people, congestion is a big issue, so we don't have it perfect at this point, but we're working on it. Even with respect to our transit system, where we're putting automatic train controls to help the trains to operate more efficiently and so on. We're trying with respect to as simple things like even with our city hall, the lights, when the lights go off, how that's done, coordinated in a way. But more importantly though, we have a whole tech ecosystem where people are working in the film sector, where they're using technology to create innovation. And so our collaboration, for example, between Toronto and Los Angeles, post-operative work are being done here, and people are able to view it in real time and send the information there through broadband and so on. It's just amazing. Now we're becoming a city of 5G technology, because we really need to get there so that people who are working at their desks And are collaborating with people, whether or not that's Australia, the UK, Europe, or the United States, Africa, or other parts of the world, utilizing technology to ensure that they can get things done just in time. We invest a lot in technology to help us with respect to our business processes. It's extremely important. The problem that we have with governments typically is that they have to make that investment first. And generally, people want to see the return before they make the investment. You have to be aware that in order to utilize technology, you have to make that decision the technology is good for you, and then you do the research, and you ensure then that once you've done your research, you're committed to putting the resources and investing in it so that you can get the benefits and so on. Sometimes it doesn't get realized right away, but over time it materializes and so on. So technology and innovation for us as a municipal government and how we see our city is extremely important. Even with respect to our transit system, we're automating, you press their card. You use a card, you press, and we're going to go using the cell phones at some point. So all of these things will make the lives of our citizens easier, will allow the flow of people movement much easier. And at the end of the day, as a government, we believe that we've got to get things done for our citizens and visitors who come in as well, right? So all of these different groups, we rely on technology to help us to move some element of the activities and the tasks that we perform for them to A, make it more efficient. It's easier through the efficiency, providing more time for people to be able to have for themselves and their families, and even with respect to their work. So it isn't a surprise to me that we in Toronto recognize it, because we've been planning for quite some time. Well, I think what's really important, though, is that our relationship with companies and our citizens, we partner now with people who know more than we do, organizations like yours, for example, right? We would look at you, and you are expert in the field. We then decide how we can work with your organization in order to ensure then that we can get the best for our citizens. So technology is extremely important. We embrace it. We've adapted it. We've accepted it. Even every young person in the city is now plugged in. We also ask them to plug out every now and then just to give their brains a rest and so on.
Absolutely. Thank you, Deputy Mayor.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure. All right. Thank you so much.